Let's full start our lesson four. Today lesson we'll go through our LO4. As you know me, my name is Anjum Sattar. If you have any question, please drop me an email and you're at ukversity.co.uk. I'll try my best to get back to you as soon as possible. Okay, so today lesson will be our LO4, which is about recommend the range of chain leadership approaches to chain initiative. So we had a discussion about different chain models. We discussed about the model of chain, Levin's quarterly step, Levin three steps. We discussed about, you know, the cultural model, Husted, Handy. We mentioned, you know, the different leadership. Now we will key focus will be on the different leadership style. Okay, so please, if you have question, you can. So today lesson key indicative content, what we supposed to be keywords, you know, which we need to be learned. So leadership approaches to context of the task, you know, activities are the challenges to determine leadership style and management approaches. A situational leader, transformational leaders, psychometric leaders, which we'll go through approaches, you know, niche theory, influence of behaviors. We'll go look around the impact, you know, of the challenging initiative by leader, increase the control time, increase the activities, opportunities, select the best, you know, approach to apply. So impact, you know, the challenge that it imposed, opportunity and reduce and even negated, and the use of the chain agent in the initiating and editing chain. So we can look around the chain models, the benefit and disadvantages of the key model of chain, including quarterly step model of chain. We can look around the Levin chain management model, McKenzie 7S approach, and the quarter dual operating system with address, you know, both entrepreneurial ideas and strategy. The chain, you know, scope, you know, the model and application of the power politics and the cultures chain. ADKAR model we discussed about in the past as well, awareness, desire, knowledge, abilities, and reinforcement. That's quite crucial, you know. So these are, what is the leadership? Leadership is mean anyone who has the power to influence another is called leader. Leaders have the ability. Leaders can see long term. Leaders make the change. Think about Steve Jobs. Think about, you know, Facebook leaders and various other leaders. So we can look around what the leader is important, and the leader with the strong leadership skills can easily motivate, which we can look around. Motivation is the most important asset that keep, you know, staff motivated and help, you know, increase the productivity, reduce the waste, you know, and the leaders should have the capability to do so. Anyone, any question, please? Okay. There are the different theories of the leaders, trait theory, the certain traits of the characteristics are the associated with effective leader. Great man theory suggests the leaders can be born with the innate qualities and make, you know, the natural leaders. So we can look around then behavior theory, leaders can be trained, adopt effective leaders, the managerial great. Identify different management style based on the leader's focus on the task or the relationship. Situational leader, effective leadership depends on the situation and the follower abilities and needs. We can Hersey-Benkard model, which we can look around, proposes that the leaders should be adjust, you know, their style based on the follower level of reading that. Transformational leader, the leader inspire and motivate, you know, the follower to achieve the shared vision. But we can be transformational leaders, which identify the four key components. Transformational leaders idealize, influence, inspirational, motivational, intellectual, which we can look around, identify the influence, inspirational, motivation, intellectual stimulation, and individualized, you know, consideration. We can look around. Authentic leadership, the leaders who are self-aware of the transparent and ethical can inspire and trust and loyal the followers. So Bill George, authentic leadership model, which is emphasis on the important, who's true themselves, you know, their values, who built, you know, authentic relationship with the followers. So servant leadership, the leadership priorities that needs to be followed in the organization over their own interests, which emphasize the importance of the leaders who serve others, who prioritize the needs of the organization over their own personal gain. Okay, so we have different leadership approaches which we can look around the situational leader, that leaders which is according to the situation, like COVID-19 had happened, the style need to be accordingly direction, supportive style with experience of employees who are more autonomous. Transformational leader, the approach, the focus, inspiring, motivating follower to achieve the shared vision and the goal, which can be particularly effective situation, the charge, innovation, and need. Psychodynamic, the leaders which is dynamically, they accord these approaches emphasizing understanding the unconscious motivation and dynamic, individual and the group. They can be particularly you the situation where the interpersonal conflict and the power struggle, and they help, leaders to understand and address, underlying the dynamics. So that's quite crucial. Image theory, which we can look around, influence the behaviors based on the idea that the shaping the environment, also known as the choice of architecture, one can influence the likelihood that the option is the chosen over another individual. So we can look around what are some example of niche behaviors. Example of niche behaviors include the sending people reminder schedule, doctor's appointment, ensuring the healthier food is the more noticeable, the cafeteria, providing the people with the information regarding how the electricity they use, and reminding people what the audience will see and they is about, the post and social media. Okay, seven stages of nudge, which we can define your changes. Clearly, we can look around, consider the changes from the perspective of your employees. Use the evidence, show the best, the choice. Then look around, present the change as an option. Listen to the feedback. Restrict the obstacle and monitoring and momentum with the short-term win. That's really we need to be focused. So examples, what are the nudging and can't benefit to workforce? Classical economics relies on the assumption that the human beings are the rational, and the behavior economics relies on the human is irrational. Yes, classical assumptions are the human beings are rational, and the behavior economics realize the human are irrationally. So behavior economics are the foundation of the nudging introduced by Teller and Sexton in 2008. And nudge make, the use of the human key, which we can look around the yield favorable intention. All this we need to be focused. Nudge management is the method that promising to help efficiencies, productivity in organization. It is simple and quick and cost effective. However, the nudging generally should be enjoyed with the caution and the open up opportunity for the dissent and the people reaction and cannot be predicted. Okay, initiative of the change according to Hayden. Can change initiative involve the thinking like identifying the problem opportunity that's in integrating, and we can need to be changed, exploring the alternative solution and securing the resource, that we need to be look around. It's quite good, effective all in all the areas in the crucial initiated by the top management, common, yes, middle management, most influence, excuse by the top management, middle management, and all, and they imply support for the chain. That's, we need, when we have that's, help, to achieve the key objective in the organization or the organizational objective, which is supposed to be achieved, the key target. Impact of the chain initiative, the leaders can wide range of impact, depending on the chain. Some example, increase the control. When the leaders initiate the change, increase the control over the organization, it can greater efficiency and consistency decision making. For example, the leaders might centralize the decision authorities in order to ensure that all decisions are in line with the organization goals. However, this can lead to the decrease the autonomy and individual employees at the department, which can have a negative impact on the morale and the motivation. So increase the time when the leaders initiate the change that give the employees more time to focus on important tasks or the projects. This can lead to improve the productivity, quality of the work. But we can look around, you know, it can be, for example, the leaders might implement the new technology. That's what we need to look around. Yes, for example, the leaders might implement the new technology processes, automated, you know, routine tasks, freeing up, you know, the time which we need to be strategic, you know, the work. We need to also create, you know, resistance among the employees who feel that they can bring, you know, replaced by machines and who are uncomfortable with the new way of working. That's we can look around, increase opportunities to select the best, you know, approach. When the leaders initiate the change, they provide more options or the resources for employees to choose from, and it can lead to improve the creativity and innovation, which we can look around the leaders and that make the difference. We can look around leaders' confusion in the sea and among the employees who overall formed by or more, which we can look around. Overall, the impact of the change initiated by the leaders will depend on the many factors specified the change is being made, which we can look around for leaders to communicate, you know, clearly with the employees about reason of the change and provide the support. That's quite crucial, you know, guys. So impact of the chain that impose, you know, for example, opportunities are reduced and even negated. Chain is important, and the organization and the employees can range of impact, but both positive and the negative, which we can look around. Reduce the opportunities imposed, you know, the chain can lead to the reduced, you know, opportunity to imply the particularly if the chain involve the layoff and this restructuring the chain leaders might decide the downside of the department in order to cut the cost and resulting reduce the opportunities which we need to look around. Okay, decrease the morale. Always, you know, look around the what impact on the morale imposed, you know, decrease morale among the particular and feel they are not being consulted in that can be happen and the policies and the procedures without seeking the input. Resistance to change imposed, you know, the change can also be leads to the risk. Persistent among the employees and who feel, you know, they their options and the concern have not been taken. For example, employees might, you know, resisted for the new software and the system, workflows, process and feel, you know, such we need to be look around. Decrease the trust, we need to be look around. The imposed, you know, trust is very important in any change process. People, the cost cutting and self-service reason and lose the trust, you know, which can make, you know, difficult to implement for the future change. So overall, the impact on the change can be depend on the factors, the specific nature of the change, organization, culture, value, attitudes, and the behaviors of the employees that can, you know, huge impact. Then it leads to be adopt the ways of working. Leaders also strive to involve the employees. So these are the leaders can look around. The use of the change agent initiated and adding. So change agent is the individual or the teams, you know, who are the responsible initiate and guiding the change. And they are the typically assigned the roles which we can look around. They have a skill, identify, analyze the problem. They have to clearly with the facts and figures communicate and conduct the research, gather the data and provide the recommendation and facilitate the communication effective. 7 C's: clear, concise, complete, consideration, message need to be passed to for the successful building the support. The chain agent can help, you know, to build the support chain initiative, communicating with us, you know, the stakeholders, concern analyzing and developing and implementing the plan. The chain agent can help, you know, develop and implement the plan for the chain, including the timeline, budget, which we can look around, ensuring effectively and efficiently. We can look around the provide chain support. The chain agent can provide, you know, support implies who affected by the chain, helping adopt, you know, new technology. Chain model we discussed in yesterday, lesson four as well, unfreeze chain and refreeze. Three-step model of leavings, which we can use, you know, that's quite crucial in the chain process. The benefit and disadvantages of Burke-Quinn model of chain, which we can look around the benefit comprehensive framework, consider, you know, the wide range of the factors influence. Sometimes it's a complex and difficult, can we implement holistic approach. Organization chain, recording the chain on the area, then can be ripple effect. You know, we need to be look around the chain on the quality, like balanced scorecard model. Don't focus on the one area, it look around the chain, impact in the quality chain, impact on the employee behavior, and so on. Chain can be used, you know, diagnostic tools, identify the areas, weaknesses, potential resistance in the chain with the organization. May not be fully account of the human factors, but we need to be resistant to change emotionally. Can guide, you know, development and the strategic plan, operational change, which we need to be unique, cultural, and structural. Quarter eight step, you know, which we discussed yesterday as well, it's create the agency, build a consultation, create the VN, communicate the VN, empower the others, create quick, you know, win, build the chain and expand the chain, and the leaders can implement these steps, you know, and they need to be have a knowledge and skill. The benefit of the quarter eight step model we mentioned yesterday in our lesson, linking to the leadership, providing the clear step, you know, the framework is maybe over simplified sometime in the complex organization issue, simplify the importance of the leadership and sense of agency. So that is unique, you know, the culture and the environment. Sometimes if don't have it, that can create, you know, provide the roadmap, stakeholders, and can be challenging. Implement the large, complex organizational change, you know, they have a resistant and driving and restrained forces according to the force field model of the living. So can the tailor the fit, you know, specific needs and require an emphasis. Okay, then we have ADCAR model. ADCAR is mean you need to be create the awareness, you need to create desire, knowledge, abilities, and reinforcement, like in our yesterday lesson. But the leaders need to do these. Leaders should be aware of what impact will be. Leaders should be aware of the desire of leader has the knowledge and abilities, and they have the reinforce, you know, that chain in the organization. Then we have ADCAR benefit. We can look around the focus on the individual level of chain, helping individual to understand and navigate the chain, and may not be fully amount of the broader organization environment. It provide clear framework, may not be suitable for the large, can be used to guide the development of the chain, may be less effective, can be tailored to the specific needs, may not be. So everything what we do, you know, it has own advantage and disadvantages. Then we have a McKinsey 7S approach. As we mentioned in our previous lesson, McKinsey is the one of the company consultant in and study in the Harvard Business School, set up, you know, and the focus on these, you know, the key areas. Soft approach is the human resource. Humans is the most important asset, and the style and the staff and the skills and the hard, you know, your strategy, your structure and system need to be designed if you want to implement the change. So benefit and disadvantages of 7S approach, which is given by McKinsey, to provide the comprehensive framework. You can look around all assets. Sometimes can be difficult to implement and complex structure. Emphasize the implement and align between the organization component strategy. May not fully amount of external environment can't be, can create a hurdle. Provide the diagnostic, you know, the tools to identify the area, and can be time consuming sometimes. Can be used, you know, development of the chain, and maybe require the significant effort to implement, and can be tailored to fit the needs specific. It can be or may not be suitable in that, you know, the culture, and it can create the chain according to the scope, which we can look around the application, the chain. framework help an organization to understand and manage the complexity of the chain, exploring about the different dimension of the chain, include, you know, which we can look at on emphasis and taking holistic and integrated approach of the chain. Chain we can look around, it is the important to consider the role and the power and the politics and the structure that to understand and the anonymity. So which we can look around the framework according to the time, the scope, the preservation, diversity, capabilities, readiness, you know, that bring the chain in the broader and each, you know, we can look around the perspective and the range of options, then you can put the chain. Effective navigating power of the politics and the culture that, you know, you would bring the strong relationship in with the various stakeholders. Stakeholders mean anyone who has any interest in the business is a stakeholder. So guys, we need to be understand who they are, what they're initiating, what can policies and procedures can be. So then you can bring the change. And change ultimately is quite crucial, you know, in our organization perspective. Ensure the leaders are the visible, actively engaging in the change process. That's, you know, which we can look around the chains, strategic communication, effective communication. Leaders change, you know, should be considered the following: create a compelling vision, foster open communication with all the stakeholders, feedback, feed forward system need to be in place, tailor the communication with the different stakeholders according to their understanding, and you have know your stakeholder, use a variety of communication channel, face-to-face, mails, online, feedback, feed forward, transparent, honest, you know, communication need to be, that's, you know, and celebrate the success. That's the most important. When the organization achieve the change, you have to be take, you know, then because that will help you the future change program which you want to be implement. That is very crucial if we can carry on engaging with the stakeholders and all. Anybody, any question, please? Guys, any question? So today we had a discussion about different leadership style and we contextualized with the chain model those can be implemented. So we had a discussion about live in three-step model, unfreeze, chain, and refreeze. We discussed about ADKAR model. We discussed about 7S model. We discussed about, you know, Levin's four-field model. We discussed about leadership style, transactional leader, transformational leader, situational leader, reinforcement leader. We discuss about different theory. The leaders are by birth leaders. Leaders can be, and we discuss behavior and trait theory. We discuss about nudging, classical, and the behavior economics. And that's, you know, all was in our lesson abbreviation. So please, if you have any question, feel free. Do a bit background reading. And we have all the handouts available on our Moodle page. And our next lesson will be about assignment discussion, which we'll go through next week. Until that point, go through the slides, read, you know, and make sure you have some your own prepared handouts. So that will help you. Okay, thanks for attending, and I will speak to you next week. Thank you. Bye-bye. Enjoy weather. Thank you.